Welcome to Meacham's Gone Farmin' Vintage Tractor Auction, featuring the only classic tractor auction of its kind in the country. Today, some of the hardest to find tractors in the world will hit the auction block. So sit back and relax and enjoy Meacham's Gone Farmin' Vintage Tractor Auction.
Hi, folks, and welcome back to the Spring Classic, the 2014 Spring Classic, that is, from Davenport, Iowa. Pat and Max with you once again this week. And if you were with us last week, you saw some pretty neat tractors go through, and kind of the prices were all over the map, Max.
Yeah, we had some that were for entry level and some that were for the more serious collector.
We've got a whole bunch more coming up this week, so stay right where you are. This is the Meacham Gone Farmin' Antique Tractor Auction on RFD-TV. Lot number F45 coming up next, 1935, Aulis Chalmers. This is a WC. This is a this tractor is being pulled in, but it is selling at no reserve.
Yeah, selling at no reserve. It's got original rear tires on it with round spoke wheels. And, of course, Aulis Chalmers was the first tractor company to come out with a tractor on pneumatic tires. And, of course, the old, we call them, some people call them unstyled WCs. I call them the flat-top WCs. Of course, there was a later version that looked more like a WD with the bullet tank and the rounded. Those tractors there, I mean, it's an iconic tractor because of the fact that the Aulis Chalmers is one of the first ones. And this one being a 35, it's a pretty early one.
Yeah.
I think 32 or 33 was when they came out with the WC. And, of course, it's set up to cultivate two rows. Very neat tractors to drive. The Aulis Chalmers engines just have that neat little sound to them. And
well, we don't know on this one. I have no indication why it's not running. But, you know, if somebody's looking to get into the antique tractor business or maybe had a grandfather that grew up with one of these, this would be a very affordable entry into this world. If right now, the price is about $1,400. They're looking for $1,500.
Yeah, and it's an absolute.
And it's sold for $1,250. Sold, no reserve. All right, rolling in here next. We have the a neat little Farmall. It's got some implements on it.
Yeah, we got a Farmall Super 8, and it does have the one-row cultivator mounted on it, so it looks like it probably come right off the farm. It does have the shields to protect the small crops when they're real short to keep you from burying them with the dirt as you bring them in. So.
Yeah, it's got the wheel weights on it, and you know, this is not a professional restoration, but it's got some fresh paint on it. And again, it looks like this old tractor could go out and do some work, and the guy could have some fun on it. He could run that tractor through a parade and not be embarrassed.
Yeah, a guy could go out and cultivate his garden if he's got a little garden stand or whatever for cultivating his vegetables. It'd be a good tractor to use for that. So.
This is lot F46, looking at about $2,500 looking for right now. The reserve is off. This tractor is going to be sold here momentarily.
And, of course, that offset design, it made the vision while you're cultivating. You look right down on the row. So.
Still trying to eke out that last bid. They're starting to roll, and it is last call. $2,250, that little Super A Farmall is sold. All right. Well, we've got a 1970 John Deere 4020 coming in here now, Max. It's got the power shift. It has been nicely restored. It's got the front weights, the working lights. It's a nice tractor.
Yeah, and it's got the factory ROPS, or rollover protection system is what Deere called it. And they were the first ones to come out with it to protect the operator in the event of a rollover. It created a safe zone between the hood of that tractor and the top of the ROPS. If that tractor rolled over and you had your seatbelt on, you were going to survive that wreck. And of course, I love it when they come in here with these things and they got the lights going and the flashers kind of just draws more attention to it. But 4020 power shift with the factory ROPS on it, dual hydraulics, 3-point, looks like newer rubber all the way around. So sounds like a good, honest tractor, nice looking paint on it.
Great classic John Deere body style of this this particular model, this 4020. This is a no reserve auction, so again, a confident seller that he's going to get his dough. And right now they're looking at around $20,000 for this tractor. So again, kind of up there at the top range of what we've been selling today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they've been selling pretty hot, the 4020s. Any of them, the four-digit 20 series, I guess, is the way I'm going to describe them from now on, because you had the 20 series in the two-cylinder, but that was a three-digit. So, but these tractors here, I mean, we're asking 22. We've got 20,000 on it. I mean, they really sell well anymore. So.
Well, they got 22.5. Now they're looking for 25,000 on this tractor. Wow, now they've got 25,000 on this tractor. No reserve. I want to thank everyone for staying with us here at the Mississippi Valley Fair Center in Davenport, Iowa, the fourth annual Spring Classic Mecum Antique Tractor Auction, and we are getting close to selling this Lot F47 on the first day, Friday. We had a bunch of collectibles and signage and neon sold earlier. Now we've got Lot 47, so we're a little over halfway through the Friday auction here, and they are trying hard to get the few extra dollars out of this 1970 John Deere 4020. The reserve was met, or no, there is no reserve, so this one has been selling all along, but right now they're hovering around that 26.5 range on this one, Max, and there is the hammer. $26,500 for a tractor. All right, we've got F48 coming in here next, Max. This is a Massey Harris 44-6. Don't know a lot about this tractor. Looks to be in pretty nice condition. Not a, you know, not as pristine a restoration job as we've seen, but a pretty nice tractor.
Yeah, still a good-looking tractor. It's got new tires all the way around. Of course, there was a Massey Harris 44, had the four-cylinder in it, and this is a 44-6, so this one has a six-cylinder in it. Massey Harris liked putting those little bit bigger engines in there and just kind of playing around to fill a niche for a horsepower range with the transmission that they had for the 44. So kind of a unique tractor. You don't see them every day. So
trying to get $3,000 out of this little tractor. Like the rain's holding off outside. There's been a little bit of mist today, so there's been some rain, some water on these tractors, but for the most part we're staying dry. But I wouldn't put it in the warm category today outside.
No.
Here in Davenport.
No, but it's still been a decent day down here, and of course it brought the crowd out. So,
well, the crowd has not thinned a bit. In fact, I'd say it's even a little thicker than it has as we get into you know, the second half of the first day of this Gone Farming Spring Classic here in Davenport. And now we're looking at $2,500 on that tractor. I have not gotten an indication if there is a reserve. I didn't hear if he sold it. Yep, this one is selling. So this 44-6, once the hammer falls, is going home to somebody else. $2,500.
Now we have Bob with Shocker Hitch. First off, Bob, tell me a little bit about how Shocker Hitch has a relationship with the Mecum Auctions.
Well, this started from our customers. A lot of our customers are tractor pullers and collect tractors and our farmers and so on. And actually, one of my customers said, why don't you get a hold of Mecum? They've got a tractor auction coming up. And so I did, and that was an auction ago, and so this is my second auction, and that's how it all started.
So how does your product fit into all of this?
Well, if you're a tractor collector, you're also pulling trailers. It's just part of the deal. So our hitches help, whether it's pulling a tractor or a boat or any kind of an equipment trailer, our hitches will help smooth that towing action out, and this is just a natural group.
Tell me about some of the products that folks here coming to the auction might be looking at.
Well, we've got our receiver hitch. Everybody has a bumper pull trailer. It's just, if you're a farmer, if you're in the mechanical field, in any way a collector, you've got a bumper pull trailer, along with a gooseneck hitch. All right, gooseneck trailers have a characteristic where they jerk on you. So when you're driving down the road, you'll feel that trailer constantly buck. And what we've done is we've built a hitch that has a back and forth cushioning action. So when the trailer jerks, boom, it feeds that energy back into an airbag. And when it does that, it gives you a nice smooth ride and absorbs those jerks so you don't have to feel them.
So if you got a cup of coffee that you're riding with, and that's it's not going to be flying all over the place?
Basically, that's it. You can drink your coffee. One of my customers once told me, you know, I love this so much because I'm not spilling Mountain Dew on my lap anymore. This hitch has a little vertical cushioning action to it. Bumper pull trailers have a tendency of pounding. When you go over railroad tracks and so on, you'll get a secondary pound. But one of the beautiful things about this hitch is its adaptability. Right now we have a combo mount, and it has a height adjustment built into it. All right. But along with that, we've got different tooling. We've got real high mounts that'll bring up the hitch height, mounts that'll bring the hitch height way down, pinel hooks for the contractors and so on. One of our most popular items for farmers, it's a drawbar. So you can pull your hay wagons and anhydrous and so on with this hitch also and get the cushioning effect. So I guess the flexibility is probably one of the beautiful things about this hitch. And then, of course, the smooth ride and less breakage on your equipment and so on.
All right, Bob, this looks like a great product that a lot of people can use. Thank you so much for telling us more about it. Thank you. Have a great weekend at the Gone Farming Antique Tractor Auction.
Another beautiful green paint job on this one, a 1941 John Deere BWH. There's only 259 of these built, another two-cylinder documentation. It's got the rear spoke wheels on it, the 40-inch. You know, it's an older restoration, Max, but this is still a really, really nicely represented John Deere.
Yeah, this one here, since it's been restored, has not spent much time outside, obviously because of its scarcity and rarity, but... very nice, very unique tractor. I mean, they're very desirable, too. I mean, a lot of people like them. And I don't know if you said that this is no reserve on one of our feature tractors, so it's going to a new home.
Well, and that's, that speaks a lot about the Mecum organization. Dan and Dana, the family, they bring these buyers and sellers together. And if you bring a tractor here, there's a really good chance it's going to bring what you want. So
yeah.
They're able to attract these no-reserve sellers. And this one is no exception. Right now, about $9,000, the current bid on this one.
And, of course, the big thing is on these is that 40-inch round spoke rear rubber. That's what really makes the BWH. They had a little bit taller front end on them in the wide front, but that's what really makes this tractor what it is.
Now right at $10,000. We've got a $10,000 bid, now looking for $10,500. Gavel Falls at 10,000 on S41. That 41 John Deere. Now we've got another 72 John Deere 4020 high crop. This is a late style high crop. This 54 high crops were built in 1972. 4020s anyway. It's been completely gone through mechanically. In addition to a stellar restoration job. Really nice paint, decals, stripes, tires. This is a valuable, this has got to be a feature tractor.
Yeah, this is one of our feature tractors, and of course, the scarcity of it, there are only 54 total 4020 high crops built in 72, and there were 16 of them were power shifts.
Oh,
so,
goodness. Right now, about $25,000 on this tractor. Now they're getting up, inching up towards 30.
And of course, side console. Dual hydraulics, got the three-point arms on it. So, I mean, just the tires got a little bit of wear on them, but those Rice and Cane tires, they still look good, even with about 50% tread on them. So, got the fenders on it, pretty much ready to go.
And they're at $30,000, and no indication whether or not the seller's ready to pull the trigger, but we'll learn that here in moments. Got 31.5 bid, looking for 32. Now now there's some activity as the thing starts rolling out the door. We're at 34,000, looking for 35. Dan and Paul are talking to the owner to see if perhaps the reserve will be lifted. Got some internet bids on this one, of course, given its rarity and condition. No surprise there. Bid goes on, it looks like. Sounds like they want closer to 40 on that one. But you know what? As rare as that tractor is, it's probably worth it. You know,
yeah.
The seller knows what he wants, and he's got a very unique and a fantastic-looking tractor there.
And we're getting real close on a lot of these tractors. It's just taking a few more thousand to make them go. So.
And now we've got another 4020, a 1972 model coming in. This is an S43. Again, another one in great condition. It's got excellent mechanical condition. And there was 38 with the Synchro Range tractors built in 1972. So, again, another beautiful example of a high crop here in the same vintage as the one right before.
Yeah, and this is just the other side of that. 16 of the power shifts built. This is the 38, the other one of the other 38 with the Synchro Range in it. So, of course, very close to the same level of restoration as the other one. This one here has single hydraulics, where the other one had dual hydraulics. So really, other than transmission and that, very close
very
to the
similar.
Same condition. So. This is another one of our feature tractors here, too.
This is right at $20,000 right now. Looking for 25,000. $22,500 was the final bid. Again, the bid goes on. No surprise on that one. S44 is coming in here next. This is another 1972. That's our third 72 in a row. This is a John Deere 4000 diesel. There were 247 of these built in 1972.
Yeah, with the power shift transmission in them. So kind of an unusual girl here. So
it's got rear and front weights, three each, two hydraulic boxes, new lighting, wiring, all the lights work.
And, of course, these 4,000, that's another one that's been real hot lately as far as the prices. And being a 72, I think they made them for another year or two after this, kind of transitioning into the 30 series tractors. So.
$30,000 currently bid. Trying to get it up to 32.5 at the moment. Got internet bid going on this one as well. $34,000 bid, looking for 35. Paul is talking to the owners to see if we're getting close to the reserve on this one.
Yeah, and beautiful restoration and paint job on this. It's got the extra wheel weights on it and everything, front weights on it. So, I mean, it's pretty much set up the way people like them. So.
$36,000 is what they're looking for. They currently have 35. Looks like they have it on the internet.
How about 35.5? Now 36.5.
Reserve has been met, by the way. This one's going home.
36.5.
Well, and that's good to kind of break us out of the slump we've been in here.
A couple of, oh, we just got an internet bid of 36.5. Speaks to the condition and the rarity of this tractor.
Yeah, and the restoration quality on that is just beautiful. So,
36.5 on the internet. Another one going to a new owner, S44. Wow, another beautiful John Deere. We've just had, I don't know if we've ever seen this many nicely restored, mid, you know, 60s, 70s model John Deere, but the last several tractors have been amazing. This is no exception. This is an S45, a 61 John Deere, 4010, another high crop. There were 170 diesel high crops built this year. It's got a complete engine overhaul, new Rysocane tires, obviously a beautiful paint job, certified two-cylinder.
Yeah, and those of you who were at a Gathering in the Green here a couple weeks ago in this fine city of Davenport, this was a tractor that we had at the Meekum booth down there promoting the auction, and I had a nice long talk with the owner of this tractor, and it's what he likes collecting is a new generation stuff, and just a super nice guy, and I hope we can get a deal made for him here today. So.
Tractor's got single hydraulics on it.
Yeah, beautiful restoration on this tractor. I mean, in a rare tractor at 170 built, so.
Right now the bid's about 20, what do they got, 26.5, looking for 27.5.
You get 6, count 27.
Now we got 26, looking for 27. 27 looking for 28.
And of course the 4010, that replaced the 30 series John Deere, so.
$28,000 looking for 29. $28,000. So the gentleman got what he wanted, and somebody's got an amazingly unique and beautifully restored tractor. Now we're going to break up with the green a little bit here and bring back in a Minneapolis Moline. This is a 1948 S46. This is another high crop tractor. There was 858 of these built, the UTC model. This is a no reserve auction. The second owner, it's got a really nice paint job. Their original style of decals, put like they were when this thing was new. New steering wheel, new brakes, new gauges, a recent engine overhaul. Nice example of a Minneapolis Moline.
We don't see many Minneapolis Moline high crops come through, and this is a nice restoration. It looks like original rear tires on it. Of course, it says this, I believe, somewhere here. It said this is a two-owner tractor right now. New gauges, new exhaust manifold, and try and find exhaust manifolds for these. And it's had a complete manifold on it, so the work's done here. Selling at no reserve as one of our feature tractors. So. And, of course, the U's, they had a hand clutch on them instead of a foot clutch because of the way that platform set up and everything. You couldn't quite get your foot up over the axle housing to push on a clutch pedal. So. You just don't see many of those high crop Minneapolis Molines come to the market to be sold. So
$8,500. $8,500, S46. Another one in this sold category, and S47, another Minneapolis Moline coming in. This one is a 62 model. It's an LP tractor. It's a 706, and this has got that classic yellow and brown Minneapolis Moline paint for that vintage. There was only 370 of these were built. So, again, a very rare tractor and a super, super nice restore job.
Yeah, and this one here with front wheel assist, beautiful restoration on it, which it's worthy of with only 370 built. Dual hydraulics, good tires all the way around, and that's another one of these things, these ones with the mechanical front wheel drive on them or front wheel assist on them. They just, they always bring more money, it seems like, because it was a rare option. I mean, that was just really coming into the market at that point. So.
You know, we haven't seen Maxa drop down in the crowd at all. There's
no.
Been, in fact, I'd say it might continue to build as these feature tractors continue to come through. But a lot of interest in these last several tractors in particular.
Yeah, I mean, this has been some of the rarest of the rare tractors that we can offer here. And as you can see, I mean, they're starting to filter even out of the doors here, just trying to get a front row seat to see these tractors come through and onto the block. So.
This is another tractor that got a lot of interest. Also, we've had some internet bids on this one, so it's got that unique that paint job, that brown and yellow. We've got a couple of those tractors, some of them unrestored, but this one they did a nice gloss paint on both colors. It looks great.
Yeah, and it looks real neat with that brown propane tank, just kind of looks like it's floating on the top of that hood. So
looking for $8,500 on that particular tractor, and we'll see if reserves have been met. And it is sold for $8,000. All right, so we're looking at lot number F58 now. It's a 1954 Farmall Super MTA. Again, nice looking tractor. It might have original tires or a little older tires on it, but a nice paint job. And this is a gas tractor with a narrow front end. New clutch, everything seems to work.
Yeah, new torque amplifier in it. So, I mean, the work's been done on it. Beautiful paint job on this tractor.
So here, yeah. And that just flew past 5,000 and just met the reserve. So once again, another great example of an antique tractor that's going to have a new owner here shortly. We've got another 15 or 20 more tractors yet today, and then a full day tomorrow, about double what we've had today. Antique tractors, implements, memorabilia, collectibles, so many things for the antique tractor enthusiast. Whether you've ever been on a farm or not, you've got to have some appreciation for all the great vehicles and the history that's running through here today. We're around the $6,000 mark on that 54 Super MTA Farmall. Sold for $5,750. Another one sold.
Yeah, that wasn't a bad price for a Super MTA either. So.
All right, we've got a 1962 John Deere 1010 coming in here now. This is a gas utility tractor. It is lot F59. New front tires. It's got a real good set of rear tires, it looks like, although they're not new. Power steering. It's got the three-point. Again, there are a lot of purposes and a lot of use left in this tractor.
Yeah, once again, got the original rear tires on the back, three-point. Got the deluxe fenders, and it appears to have the deluxe seat on it. So, I mean, pretty nice little 1010. Now, you look at this one compared to the one that we had a little bit earlier. This one looks a lot bigger than the other one, and it's just the way it's set up with the tires, and it's more of a, with the utility, that was set up more for two rows, where some of them were set up for one row, and just a neat little tractor. So, and of course, made up here in Dubuque, just a few miles north of us. So.
This is another no reserve on this tractor. This one is going home to the highest bidder. And it's right now, they're $3,400. They're looking at $35,000, going up to $4,000 right now.
Yeah, and the paint on this tractor is beautiful for a guy selling it no reserve. So
Great looking classic John Deere look on this tractor too. It's got the lights mounted up there. And again, the paint's beautiful. And we're at 4250 they're looking for. They've got 4,000 bid on this tractor.
Yeah, that's a nice price on that tractor for what it looks like in appearance. So.
And it's sold for $4,000. F59. Looks like we had some internet traffic on that tractor as well. So now we've got F60 coming in here, and this is again an absolute sale, no reserve, a Farmall 350, completely restored, shined like a diamond when it drove by here a moment ago. It's got a 2-point hitch, less than 50 hours since the complete overhaul. It's got the rear weights on the wheels, a new steering wheel, new front tires and rear tires, and it's got power steering on this new truck.
Yeah, and power steering at this point was just starting to come in on a lot of these tractors. So, I mean, once again, another nice paint job on the tractor. It's got the fast hitch on it, the 50 hours since a complete overhaul. I mean, guy's got some money in it, and this is just a good typical example of how IH was updating these tractors and making them look a little more modern. A little more operator comfort.
Yep. Got a little more styling on these tractors.
I've always liked the paint scheme on these tractors with that red and white. It really makes them stand out. So.
I'd hate to see how you could buy this tractor, restore it, redo the motor, and put tires on it, you know, for around $6,000,
right,
which is what this thing's bringing right now.
It doesn't happen unless that tractor was super nice to begin with.
Right.
A lot of this stuff, you look at paint and that. Some of these, when you got paint on them, they're... The paint jobs are about $4,000 and $5,000 paint jobs, so
$7,250 is what they're looking for right now. $7,100. I just saw Dan Meekham get a bid from the gentleman in the second row. So the crowd has not thinned a bit from when we started here a few hours ago, Max. $7,100. That one is sold at no reserve.
Ladies and gentlemen,
and now we've got an original high crop John Deere coming in here now. And this is a 1955 John Deere 40H. 40H was only built in 1955. Only 294 of them were built. And this is looks like number 186.
Yeah, and these things here, just selling at no reserve, to find a good original 40, or a good original high crop, anything is tough, but a 40 high crop in original condition, I mean, tin straight on it. It looked like you could actually see the original dealership sticker on the side of the hood.
Yeah.
Tires look like they may have been replaced on this tractor at some point. They're mismatched.
On the left.
They're kind of mismatched, but I'll tell you what, a good, honest, original tractor. I mean, you kind of see what they look like when they were new. Looks like it's got a couple new parts. Looks like the generator and the carburetor and that have been done. You got to do some of that, because this tractor here didn't look this way original just by going out and working. It's been sitting for a little while somewhere. So.
And right now, the current bid is $7,750, and it's a no-reserve auction once again. I got to give credit to the Meekham boys for bringing in all of these great sellers that are willing to put their tractors in at no reserve. And, you know, when you're dealing with Meekham, there's not a lot of risk there, because they bring in the buyers. And they bring in the folks online, and they bring, obviously, can draw a huge crowd. So a very successful auction for both buyers and sellers on the deal with Meekham. And this one's starting to roll out the door, this 55-40H high crop, and it is selling at around the $8,500 mark. $8,250 as the hammer falls. Wow.
And this is another little unique tractor.
Real unique. You don't see these every day. This is a 1949 Alice Chalmers G. And this is lot number F63. And I have a feeling this one's going to bring some dough.
These usually sell pretty good. Of course, this one here doesn't have any attachments on it, but this is, once again, another little vegetable farm tractor. They were great. They had a one-bottom plow that mounted up in the front in that hoop that goes underneath. As you just watch Paul one of our ring men grabbed the front end of that tractor and lifted off the ground. You kind of feel like that when you're sitting on those because they are light in the front, but they had a one-row cultivator you could put on them, or they had planter units. You'd go out as much as four rows planting narrow-row crops, your lettuce and stuff like that. And, $4,000, I mean, sound like a good running tractor. And he's got that thing set up so that the wheels are out wide. It really makes it look neat.
Got a great look to it. Sold for right at $4,000 at F63. Now we've got an original 1965 Case 730 coming in here next at F64. It seems to run good. And this one probably came right out of the field. This one has been not restored. Probably got the original tires on it.
Yeah,
looks
it looked
like a pretty good workhorse.
Looks like those rears might have been replaced at one point, but got the three-point hitch on the back. Kind of a straight tractor, really. I mean, it's got some fade to the paint, but it's pretty straight and honest. Power adjuster wheels on it. So, and of course, the cases, the Comfort King, you had the fenders and everything, the platform you set up higher, you really felt good up there on top of that tractor. So,
right, the 65 case is right now at $2,500. We're looking actually now at $3,000. We've got $2,750 bid.
And of course, this is a gas tractor. Once again, some cheap horsepower here. I mean, those old cases, they didn't run real fast, but man, the bore and stroke on those things was long, and you could lug them right down. They had a lot of torque. So,
right at $3,000, they're looking for. Not have an indication on the reserve yet, but I do see Matt with the gavel. $2,750, and that one is, the bid goes on, what they tell me. The bid goes on that tractor. All right, coming in here next is a 1951 John Deere BW, wide front end, original paint, being towed in, so it's not running under its own power, but what a neat original tractor. A lot of patina on this one.
Yeah, and original rear tires, the tin looks nice and straight on it. Looks like someone put a different exhaust pipe on it or a different muffler on it. So, but also the other thing that's neat to look at on this is if you look at the back, you're used to seeing a rock shaft or lift arms on the back. This has got the flat back. There's no hydraulics. It's just a flat back with a PTO. So this tractor evidently was ordered this way, and you don't see many bees that did not have the lift because bees were just a favorite for guys cultivating. So
we've got a bid over here right next to us. There are $2,100 on this tractor.
Yeah, and of course a bee with a wide front, especially a late bee with a wide front, is tough to find. So
trying that last as they try to roll this thing out. They're trying to get $2,200 on this 51 John Deere BW factory wide front. And it guy next to us just bid one time. He's one of those one-time bidders. We sold it for $2,100.
Yeah, I don't know if that motor was stuck on that tractor, but that was a neat tractor to see come through.
Right now at F66, we've got a 1965 John Deere 4020, another workhorse. Look at the back end of this thing. It's just massive.
Yeah, I always like
original condition.
Yeah, I always like these with the big wide fenders on them. They're always a neat-looking tractor, but you just think about the amount of cast iron in that rear end housing and what that must weigh on its own. And this is a synchro range transmission on this. Looks like it's got pretty decent rubber all the way around, so nice looking tractor.
Got the fender. They got a little few dents and dings. They got some character.
Oh, yeah.
The rear fenders, but,
yeah, and what it is maybe the hired hand had a little too much fun the night before, and he turned a little short, and that piece of equipment rolled up on that tire and dinged that fender up. So
right now we're at $6,500 on they're looking for $6,500 on this.
Yeah, not a bad price at all on that tractor. I mean, you're getting a lot of iron for your money right there. So
they've got 65 bid on the 65 John Deere 4020. Now, I haven't got an indication on the reserve, but it looks like Matt might be putting the gavel down. The bid goes on at $6,500 on that 65 John Deere 4020. It is a 1941 Farmall H. Coming up next, this F67 is a 1941 Farmall H. Totally overhauled. New clutch, new radiator. It's got an extra hood included, but those fenders don't look like they came factory on that tractor.
No, those fenders would be off of like a 706 or an 806. Those there with that set of fenders on, it's just a little bit different deal. So
this is a no reserve auction. Tractors kind of letting everybody at the lower price jumping in on this one. It's a $1,200. We're looking for $1,200 right now on this tractor.
At that affordable price point for everyone. So. And of course,
that tractor's even got a rear view mirror mounted on those fenders.
Yeah,
right?
he must have been using it for tractor rides and everything. Might have been somewhere he could mount his cooler up there and keep his beverages cold. So,
$1,200 bid, no reserve, so that's going to go away. We've got $1,100 bid. F67 is down the road. We've got a buyer. All right, coming up next is F68. This is a 1950 John Deere M. Again, a no-reserve auction. Neat little tractor. Looks like it's got a fairly recent paint job on it, decent tires, and a neat little utility tractor.
Yeah, the Model M's, of course, that was to compete with the Farmall A's and kind of that one-row tractor. But some of those, if you had light enough ground, they had a two-bottom plow that would work on there, or a single bottom. And if you look at the back where the drawbar is on the back, that's actually a lift that was to kind of compete with Ford with their three-point hitch. That kind of got John Deere into the market with the quick hitch type equipment and the automatic hydraulic lift and that. So.
All right, coming up next is F68. This is a 1950 John Deere M. Again, a no-reserve auction. Neat little tractor. Looks like it's got a fairly recent paint job on it, decent tires, and a neat little utility tractor.
Yeah, the Model M's, of course, that was to compete with the Farmall A's and kind of that one-row tractor. But some of those, if you had light enough ground, they had a two-bottom plow that would work on there, or a single bottom. And if you look at the back where the drawbar is on the back, that's actually a lift that was to kind of compete with Ford with their three-point hitch. That kind of got John Deere into the market with the quick hitch type equipment and the automatic hydraulic lift and that. So.
Looking at another no-reserve tractor. It's currently bid at $1,600. Looking for $1,700. $1,600 looking for $1,700. Again, this is F68. $1,600 as Matt hits the hammer down. And we've got another big John Deere coming in here. Once again, folks, Max Wilson and Patrick Holmes from the Meekum's Gone Farm and Antique Tractor Auction here. It's the fourth annual Spring Classic here in Davenport, Iowa. And we are kind of winding down with day one. And, boy, we've got a full day tomorrow of all kinds of tractors and collectibles and the like. But now we've got another one of these massive John Deere. This is a 5020 coming in. And this one, again, is a pretty nice tractor. Not a full restoration, but in pretty nice shape. And lots of horsepower.
Yeah, and, of course, this one here is a Wheatland. Has PTO and the M&W Turbo Kit, which was an aftermarket thing that some of the farmers needed a little more giddy up and go. And this, they'd put that kit on there, and it gave you a turbo, so it made that engine run a little bit harder. And you get dual hydraulic straight tractor. This is actually a friend of mine, Wyman and Sons Tractor Parts up in Minnesota. They actually are the ones that brought it down to consign it. So
it's got the front weights on it. And they are at 10.5 right now in this 50-20.
Yeah, and I mean, you look at those fenders compared to the one we had here a few minutes ago. Those fenders are a lot nicer and haven't been beat up. So.
Sold for $10,500. Well, your friend has one fewer tractors in his fleet. Well, thanks for watching this week's edition of the 2014 Spring Classic, Meekum's Gone Farming Antique Tractor Auction. And Max, I got to tell you, today in particular, I know the folks out there watching sure enjoy learning all the things that you have to teach us about these great tractors that come through.
Well, I just try my best and get a little bit of the facts and some history on the tractors out there for the people. So.
And we've got another great edition coming up next week. Now, again, this program runs Tuesdays at 5:30 Eastern at 4:30 Central, and again on Saturday at 11:30 Eastern and 10:30 Central. So be sure to tell your friends we're here every week, and we'd love to have you back. From Davenport, Iowa, the 2014 Spring Classic, it's the Meekum's Gone Farming Antique Tractor Auction right here on RFD-TV.